Wakanda forever! Come right in their feet!
Don't you dare dip me! Don't you dare dip me! Don't you dare dip me! Ow, I should have stretched.
Yes, I wouldn't be nothing if I didn't have you.
I know what you mean, Sully. Because
I wouldn't know where to go.
Me too, because I
wouldn't know what to do.
Why you keep singing my part?
I don't have to say it. I say it anyway.
Because we both know it's true.
I wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have. I wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have. I wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have. Wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have you.
One more time! And
one! I don't have to say it.
Where'd everybody come from?
All we both know it's true.
Let's take it home, big guy!
I wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have.
I wouldn't have nothing if I didn't have.
Oh my goodness. Let's check his monster in the closet. Hulk's monster in the closet. No, I don't see any monster in the closet. Oh, I see my duty clothes, my clean clothes and my Legos. Oh man, that sucks. I probably if Sully and Mike come to life and I could see them in flesh form, then I would be really creepy just like that TikTok video and I don't want to talk about. Alright, let's get started. Hello guys, this is your pal Nick It Has One here. Inside there's no monster in the closet. I probably would be really cool. Sully would scare the crap out of me and try to scream, so. Probably Cody is right. I'm probably this movie is not it's not a real life. It's just a movie about monster connect the scream and scares children. Today I'm gonna do a movie review on Frozen 2, favorite movie from the childhood. It's not Frozen 2 because Frozen 2 is not childhood. It's other than Monster Inc. Came out the year from 2001, the same year I was born. Same year of a stupid movie called Freddy Got Fingers, which honestly I don't really give a crap about. An overrated movie called Jimmy Neutron. And my second favorite movie is Shrek. Second favorite movie from 2001 is Shrek. And my favorite movie from 2001 is none other than Spirits Away. Oh, such a beautiful movie. Alright guys, let's get to the plot, shall we? Basic plot is about the other... God damn it, Chris. God damn it, Chris. I'm trying to do this review and you shrek me. Sorry, guys. Just my brother Chris shrek me. Let's get the plot, shall we? Based upon it is about the based on the opening when the one monster failed once again. So Mr. Wonder was so angry. It's so angry. So his plan is hire a bunch of monsters and scare children and connect the screams. So he hire Sully and Mike Zelke and some Sully and Mike Zelke until Sully he left his paperwork and so Sully almost grabbing his paperwork and so Sully meet that one little kid named Boo and so that little monster is scared. So Sully and Mike realize Boo don't have home, so Sully and Mike have to get Boo back her home and gate the door and stop this evil villain, Orlando, and that basic part is. Yep, I know the part because I watched this movie yesterday with Chris. Alright guys, here's on one YouTuber really loved this movie and his based on a childhood and other than it's another than Frozen 2 Fantastic Four. And I'm probably gonna give a shout out. I'm gonna give a shout out for Frozen 2 Fantastic Four. He's a great, he's a fantastic YouTuber. His favorite movie of all time is Frozen 2. Well, yeah. Yeah, I agree with him. Frozen 2 is such a fantastic movie. Screw the haters, because Frozen haters is being toxic nowadays. You know what? Let's not talk about Frozen haters, because I just don't want to get started drama. Alright, guys, I watched this movie yesterday with Chris. After I watched The Wolf for the Planet of the Apes, and that was one of the best Planet of the Apes movies I've ever seen in my life. And what did I think of it? This movie is my third favorite Pixar movie ever. My second favorite Pixar movie is other than Toy Story 2. My favorite movie from Pixar is other than Soul. Yep, Soul is my favorite Pixar movie. Out of the Pixar movie, Soul is my favorite. So is the Luca will be my favorite Pixar movie. Well, probably not, because Soul is special in my heart, so. Just like Frozen 2 and the Snyder Cut and Family Guy. Alright, so guys, I really love this movie. This movie is really funny too, just like Toy Story 2, and this movie has some funny moments. This has got to be the second funniest comedy animated movie from 2001. This movie is way better than Freddy Got Fingers, which honestly, I don't want to think about that movie. That movie is so disgusting. You never really watched it. Jeez. And so, guys, the only negative. Let's see. No, I don't have any negative. I'm probably, people would say Mr. Waldo is a weak villain. Well, Grasshopper from A Bug's Life is a weak villain. How about that? Jeez. So, guys, I don't have any negative at all. Let's get the positive. The story is really entertaining. The story is really original. The characters are great, like Sully, played by John Goodman. He was in Elvis New Groove as Pacha, and he was in The Cloverfield Lane. I haven't seen the movie. I just watched the trailer, but I haven't seen the movie. So let's get to Mike Zelke. Mike Zelke is actually one of the best Billy Crystal role ever. He's way better than he was in an awful movie, comedy movie, as Parental Guardian. I cannot believe Billy Crystal signed in for Parental Guardian. Sorry, I'm sorry. Back to what I was saying. So yeah, Mike Zelke is actually one of the best roles from Billy Crystal. It's way better than he was in Parental Guardian. Oh my god, I can't stand that movie. The movie's stupid. Alright guys, let's get to Mr. Waldenus. I'm probably people think Mr. Waldenus is a weak villain. But I kind of disagree with you. I like Mr. Waldenus. Mr. Waldenus is my second favorite villain of this movie because my second favorite scene of this movie is none other than Sully and Boo run from Mr. Waldenus, and Mr. Waldenus chase him. And it's trying to get him a child, and so Sully just walked the door. Oh my god. That scene is so dark for a Pixar movie. Pixar really love making dark scenes of a Pixar movie. This movie should be PG, not G. Jeez. This movie is kind of have a musical number, like Mac was. You know what? I don't want to spoil that scene. The climax is really entertaining, and this animation is so. It's so gorgeous. Pixar would not let this style of animation. I never seen Pixar do bad animation before. Well, you better not, because Pixar is amazing with animation. Just like Frozen 2. Frozen 2 would not let this style for the animation. What else? I'm probably Wendell. Wendell is a awesome villain. Well, people think right now Wendell is a weak villain too. Well, I kind of disagree with you. Wendell is a great villain. It's not one of the best, but a great villain. He's way better than Francis from The Boss Baby. Reason why? Because he's the voice of the same actor. So yeah, screw Francis. I don't like that villain. They're stupid. Alright, so guys, I have nothing to say about this. So overall, guys, Monster Inc. 2001, this is one of the third favorite movies from 2001, with a great story, great character. Mr. Waldo is a great, great villain, and Randall is a great villain too. And I forgot to mention Boo, the little Boo kid. Oh my gosh, she is so cute, just like young Anna and young Elsa. Yep, I put it in Frozen 2. Oh well. Alright, so guys, I have nothing to say about it. So, once again, so overall, guys, Monster Inc. 2001 is one of my third favorite Pixar movie ever, next to Toy Story 2 and Soul. I'll probably do this movie along with Shrek and Spirits Away, one of the third favorite movie from 2001. My number two is Shrek. My number one is Spirits Away from 2001. Little Miss, such a beautiful movie. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna give Monster Inc. a 10 out of 10. It's epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I cannot wait what's in store for Monster in Book. And I think it's the title is because there's a new Disney Plus show is coming on. And John Goodman and Billy Crystal is coming back for Pixar. Yay! Can't wait to see John Goodman as Sully again. Really miss John Goodman, but this is how it is, because I'm probably busy in life with the movie production. Alright guys, that was my movie review on Monster Inc. Tell me what you thought of Monster Inc. People will never hate this movie. Why, come on, it's about the hire of a monster and correct the scream. Who hate that? Oh well. I probably the story is way better than Space Chimp story. I think Space Chimp story is really stupid. Like, seriously, who want to see a movie about monkey go to space? That's really stupid, you ask me. Alright guys, comment below and let me know. And let me see what my next review is. I'm very sorry you have a Snyder Cut. Alright, my next review is Finding Nemo. Oh man, I cannot wait to talk about that movie. Sweet. Cannot wait for it. So yeah guys, I'm gonna give a shout out for Frozen 2 Fantastical. He made this thumbnail for me and I forgot to show you on my Bugs Life review. So I'm gonna give a shout out for him and thanks for the thumbnail, buddy. And also I made a thumbnail for Finding Nemo. Alright guys, stay tuned for my next review tomorrow. It's Finding Nemo. Cannot wait to talk about the movie, aka one of my best movies from 2003, right in the Canahan. We'll even think Canahan is really stupid fun, really awesome review of a movie, but it's pretty awful. I probably will respect Chris's opinion because Chris loved that movie so much, and I kind of respect his opinion. And so, guys, my next video is gonna be my commentary on Harry Thomas Frozen 2 is underrated. But don't worry, guys. This video is not gonna be bad. It's not gonna be like Giga Game or something to other one. It's gonna be like great commentary, so stay tuned for that. And stay tuned for my top 10 best anime movie of all time. I'll probably you know what movie is will my number one. Well, you better wait and see because I don't want to spoil some rest of my best movie anime movie for all time. Alright guys, if you like this more Pixar review, hit the subscribe button, turn notification, share the video with your family, and stay tuned for my review on Finding Nemo. The one movie Chris watched over and over again, and I will never hate that movie. The movie's way better than Finding Dory. And probably I get Finding Dory for a movie would be a fast rant. So if you like Finding Dory, I have a special opinion. But for me, it's still overrated. I really don't know. People just don't really like that movie instead of Zootopia. I don't understand it. Alright guys, my Pixar review is coming to a close, and I see you in my next Pixar review. It's Finding Nemo, the most beautiful Pixar movie ever. Alright guys, see you next time. So long, peace YouTube. Now excuse me, I'm gonna check if there's a monster in the closet again. God darn it, no monster in the closet. Goodbye, guys.
What would I do without you? You'll always have me.